A hair-raising confrontation today. A vicious dog terrified three people in East Walnut Hills. And as News 5's Brian Hamrick explains, the dog did not stop until officers stepped in. Brian?
Yeah, Jack, it created some serious anxiety here in Walnut Hills. The streets were crowded, and suddenly this huge pit bull starts attacking anything that moved. A couple of guys we talked to had to scale this fence and get on top of that car over there just to keep the injuries at a minimum.
I see somebody's standing on the fence.
It's the scene of an attack, but in this one, the weapon used, teeth.
Who else got that?
All right, when it bit us, we didn't jump over there across the fence to the car.
I tried to jump over the fence.
Where were you at when you got bit?
Right there. On the corner.
On the corner right there?
Quinsale Parham and Antonio Burns found themselves up to their knees in trouble and in bite wounds. They scaled a fence and jumped on a car as a large dog went on a rampage.
Yeah, he was running around chasing people. Had people jumping on cars and stuff. And like, then me and my friend happened to sit right there and he bit us.
And they weren't the only ones attacked. As police arrived, another man who didn't want to be identified says the dog got a hold of him.
The dog bit me on the leg and I had jumped up on the car. And once, you know what I'm saying, I got up on top of the car, the police officer had to take the dog down due to the fact because the dog was out of control.
At that point, the officer took action to protect the citizen and fired shots, putting the dog down.
Witnesses say the dog was shot multiple times and died immediately.
Kind of, it's a pit. It's an all-white pit, about 80 pounds.
It's sad because I love animals, but I mean, it had to be done.
No one knows why the dog attacked. Some say it's especially unusual because they had seen it in the neighborhood before when it was friendly.
Now, the dog has an owner and a caretaker. It was this caretaker who's been cited by the police and by the SPCA. Meanwhile, the dog's been sent off to see if it has rabies. That's standard procedure in a case like this. Fortunately, none of those bite wounds were serious. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, News 5.